वेलकम स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम ऑन द रेसिप्रोकेटिंग इंजन मैकेनिज्म। सो टुडेज टॉपिक न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम ऑन रेसिप्रोकेटिंग इंजन मैकेनिज्म। आई ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स, वीडियो लेक्चर्स, how to derive an expression for velocity of piston and acceleration of the piston for a slider crank mechanism. We find out the formula for the velocity of a piston is equals to r omega in bracket sin theta plus sin 2 theta by 2n, where small r is radius of the crank, omega angular velocity of the crank, and theta is the crank angle, and n is the ratio l by r, length of the connecting rod to the radius of the crank. And the formula for acceleration of the piston is r omega square cos theta plus cos 2 theta upon n in big bracket. Okay, so now I am going to discuss one numerical problem for this topic. Okay, this is the numerical problem on a velocity of piston. Okay, this is my first question. If the crank and connecting rod are 300 mm and 1 meter long respectively, and the crank rotate at a constant speed of 200 rpm, then determine the first the crank angle at which maximum velocity occurs and the maximum velocity of the piston. So we can see that from the given problem, the following data are given, like small r, which is the radius of crank, is 300 mm. If I am convert in meter, it is equals to 0.3 meter. Same L, 1 meter, that is the length of the connecting rod. Capital N is the RPM, revolution per minute, which is given 200, and omega equals to 2 pi n upon 60. This is the formula for the find out angular velocity of the crank. Then we put the value n 200. So we got value 20.95 radian per second. Okay. Now, in the question asked, crank angle at which the maximum velocity occur. We already know that. How can we achieve the maximum velocity or minimum velocity? In the 12th standard, we also use in calculus maximum and minimum problem. So we know that if we want to calculate maximum or minimum value, then for a particular equation, then we differentiate and equates to zero, then we know about the boundary condition. Okay, so here firstly we calculate a small value of n, which equals to l by r. We can see that the value of l is 1 and value of r is 0.3. then when we divided this value, then we got the value 3.33. I hope everybody understand. Now we know that the formula velocity of the piston, that is r omega sin theta plus sin 2 theta by 2n. Okay, we simply put the value. And differentiate with respect to theta and equates to zero for the maximum velocity. then we got our equation converted, because the differentiation of sine theta is cos theta and sine 2 theta is cos 2 theta upon 2, that means cos 2 theta upon 2n. So we got this equation, that is n cos theta. When we simplify the above equation, then we got this equation, n cos theta plus 2 cos square theta minus 1, because we already know that the value of cos theta is 2 cos square theta minus 1. Then we put, then our equation becomes 2 cos square theta 3.3 cos theta minus 1. This is a square equation, so we can find out the root of this equation by using the formula Sridharacharya. What is the formula of Sridharacharya? Minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. We put all the values in this equation, then we got the value of cos theta, which is equals to 0.26 if we taken the positive sign. If we taken negative sign, then we got other different value. Okay, so when we take inverse, cos inverse, then we got the value of theta. So this is the first part of the numerical. We got angle value at which we can get maximum velocity of the piston. I hope you will understand. Now second part, what is the maximum velocity of the piston? When we put this value of angle in the above equation, that is BP R omega sine theta plus sine 2 theta upon 2n, then the answer is 6.54 meter per second. So simply we can solve this kind of numerical problem in our examination. Now let us take another example for better understanding another topic, angular velocity and acceleration of the connecting rod. Okay, so let us read. In a slider crank mechanism, the length of the crank and connecting rod are 150 mm and 600 mm, that means 0.15 meter and 0.6 meter respectively. The crank position is 60 degree from the IDC in a dead center, and the crankshaft speed is 450 rpm, that is our capital N, revolution per minute, that is clockwise. Here examiner mentioned using analytical method, otherwise we can solve this is by graphical method. Determine first part, velocity and acceleration of the slider, second part, angular velocity and angular acceleration of the connecting rod. So here firstly choose the given data R, L and theta and N. Now we can calculate the value of small n, that is the ratio of L by R. So here we can calculate the value L by R equals to 4, and we divided 0.6 by 0.15. And what is the value of velocity of slider? We simply put this value in this given formula. BP equals to R omega sine theta sine 2 theta upon 2n. Then we got the value 6.9 meter per second. Same, when we want to calculate the acceleration of the slider, acceleration of the piston, then we use the formula R omega square cos theta plus cos 2 theta upon n. When we put all the given data, then we got the value of alpha p 12.94. I hope first part of this question you can understand. Now angular velocity of the connecting rod, we already derived this formula omega pc equals to omega cos theta upon n. Then we got the value of angular velocity of the connecting rod, that is 5.9 radian per second. And another formula we also derive, angular association of the connecting rod, that is alpha VC, that formula omega square sine theta upon n. So here we can calculate the value of angular acceleration of the connecting rod. So in the today lecture, I have solved two numerical problem with you. If you have any issue and doubt, then you can message me and text me. Okay, we already know that the subject dynamics of machine is totally numerical subject. Without numerical problem, we can go another topic. Okay, so numerical is very important for this subject. After each and every topic, I want to cover one numerical problem on each topic. So that's why I'm taking today numerical problem session and simple two numericals in my lecture. Thank you so much.